My first day, I was about half an hour into the race and I ran into a curb and I fell and I needed to replace my wheel. My first year on Team Tibco Silicon Valley Bank, I had never done any American pro races. I'd never raced in Europe. And so the plan was for me to do the American pro circuit. But because of COVID, all of the American races were canceled. So we had the virtual Tour de France and all of these races on Zwift, which I was able to do well at and show that I was at least strong. So when Colorado Classic, which was the last of them, got canceled, I went home to Alaska and I was feeling really down because I was like, I didn't have a season. And I got this random call from my coaches and they were like, hey, do you want to come to Europe? And I almost dropped my phone. And I was like, absolutely, yes. Like, I want to, you know, get on the next plane. And they were like, well, because of the quarantine restrictions, we actually need you to leave tomorrow. So that night I packed my bags and I flew to Europe the next day and did a 2-week quarantine in England and then arrived in France after 2 weeks of quarantine and raced in Ardèche about 2 days after I arrived in France.
Hi, I made it into France, they let me in, and this is my first spin on my bike. And now we're cycling through the beautiful Ardèche. This is the dam.
I hadn't met a lot of my teammates yet because of COVID, and I never raced in Europe, I never raced a pro race, and so everything was really new to me. So I always get really dry eyes when I ride, just the wind in my face. I've tried different sunglasses, I've tried eye drops before races, I've tried everything, and my eyes just get really dry. And so in training, sometimes I might lose one contact, but I'm normally able to get home. And I never really thought about what would happen in a race in the middle of a peloton if my contact fell out, let alone my first ever race where I'm not used to the speed and complexity of a European peloton. So we're riding along and I'm like, oh no, my contacts are starting to get dry. So I start blinking over and over and over and I'm in this group and I could feel one contact start to turn in my eye and it was folding and I was like, oh no, this is gonna fall, this is gonna fall out. So I just continue to blink and continue to blink. Meanwhile, I'm trying to stay upright. I've got people passing me to my left and my right. I'm trying to maintain my position. I'm trying to follow the wheel in front of me. This is like my first ever race in Europe and I'm super overwhelmed. And then suddenly my contact just blows out and I'm like in this group. And so I just veer to the side and I can't see anything and I just fall over. And then I'm just see people go by. And by the time I get back up, everyone was gone. And I was like, well, I can see enough to finish. So I just follow the road and I make it to the finish line and I cross the finish line and I can barely see anything, but I can see enough to recognize the signs on the vans as I'm going by. And so I just look for the team van and I don't really recognize anything, but I finally see somebody on my team who comes up to me and I was like, I can't see anything. I don't know what's going on. I think I crossed the finish line, but I'm not sure. Like, where are we? I had a bunch of scratches. I had blood on my lip. I had blood on my leg. I was all torn up because I'd fallen when I lost my contact. And that night I had a really nice teammate who came and she bandaged me up and I was like, okay, I need to make sure that they don't regret taking me. And so as the days went on, I started to feel a little bit more comfortable and she started giving me, you know, a little bit more responsibility and said, by day four, she said, you know, if there's a breakaway, you know, any one of you guys can try and chase it. And so on day four, there was a group that went and there was a breakaway and I was like, here's my chance, I got to take it. So I chased the breakaway, I got in it and we stayed away for most of the race and the race was nearing the end. Initially when I made the first break, it was like, yes, like I did something for my team. But then once it settled in, it was like, okay, now I need to live up to this responsibility because, you know, I chased it. So now I got to make sure that I stick and, you know, stay in it and actually live up to the responsibilities of actually being in the break. I was so focused on keeping the wheel in front of me that I forgot to eat. I missed the food refuel zones. I was just like super focused. My teammate actually came up to me and was like, hey, Kristen, how's it going? And I didn't even notice because I was just so narrowly focused on trying to do my job in the peloton. One of the girls in the break I was in actually just went off and she decided to go and she broke from our group. So when this girl went, I just went with her. And at that point we were a break of three and we were gapping the group behind us. And then there was the Peloton in the back. I just stayed with her and was just like, hang on, be here for when my teammate catches us, The Peloton and the group of GC leaders were starting to catch up. And my race director said through the microphone, she was like, Kristen, if you have anything in you, just go. And I was like, oh my gosh, this is my chance. And so I just went and I broke from the group of three that we were in and I just TT'd my way to the finish. And I ended up winning that stage and I put my head down. I just didn't even look behind me. I was like, this is my chance to just show what I can do. And I couldn't feel my legs. And the entire time through the radio, she was like, Kristen, I need you to go harder. And I could just sense that they were probably closing in or catching up. But I ended up crossing the finish line first. And then my teammate, who ended up winning the GC overall, she was able to kind of sit in the group that she was in and sprint toward the finish. So she got second. So we ended up getting first and second on stage four, which was amazing for me personally because it was my first ever pro race, but also for our team. And I guess my lesson from that was just to take advantage of every moment and seize it because you don't know what you can accomplish until you try. From taking the chance to even go to Europe in the first place to going in that break and then to making my own break and TTing to the finish. Just, I never would have dreamed that would happen when I first went over to Europe. So it was pretty awesome.